Hello, we are discussing about GATE 2012 ECE paper and the topic we are discussing is digital circuits. In the sum of products function, f of x, y, z is mean terms 2, 3, 4, 5 are given. The prime implicants of this function are, there are 4 options are given, A, B, C, D. Out of that one, which one is the right answer? Okay, the total number of prime implicants present in f of x, y, z, okay, sigma m of 2, 3, 4, 5 is given. Implicant, first of all, what is meant by implicant? Implicant implies nothing but every min term is going to be treated as implicant. That is 2, 3, 4, 5 are going to be treated as in this question. Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5 all are going to be treated as minterms, and these minterms are also called as implicants. The other name for the minterms is nothing but implicants. Implicants in SOP form are going to be product terms in which every variable has to be present in either complement or uncomplemented form, so that all variables must be present. That implies nothing but we generally call it as minterm in SOP expression. So implicants are nothing but minterms. Then what is meant by prime implicant? Prime implicant is nothing but, prime implicant is formed by grouping the minterms present in the expression, and while grouping consider the maximum size possible such that you are going to be getting a minimized product term. That product term is going to be called as prime implicant. And to cover all the ones present in the function, you may cover, okay, the number of cells may be more than once also you can cover. To cover all the ones present in the function, you may consider, okay, each one may be more than once also depending on the situation. So for this one, we will see what is meant by how many number of prime implicants are present in this one. This is a three variable Boolean expression, so that we must draw a three variable K map. So this is a three variable K map whose the three variables are x, y, z, and we will consider this as x and this side is y, z. So we will write the cells possibly 1, 1, 1, 0 and it is 0, 1. So this is 0, 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 7, 6. So indicate the ones in the minterms which are given in the function. So 2, 3, 4, 5 are going to be minterms present in the function. Okay. So 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you want to cover all the ones, you must cover, you must group these ones. Okay, so these two can be grouped. Whenever you are grouping this one, what you are going to get is nothing but x, y is going to be the answer. Sorry, x bar y. This is x is equal to 0, that implies nothing but x bar, y is 1, that is x bar y. Here you will get function. And this one is going to be minimized to, okay, x, y bar. And all the ones are going to be covered. So no need to cover the other ones, no need to cover the one more than once, no need to cover each cell more than once, so that these are going to be treated as prime implicants are nothing but x bar y and x y bar. These are going to be the product terms which covers all the ones possible. Okay, so the right answer for this question is A, x bar y comma x y bar. And in this question, these two prime implicants will be considered as essential prime implicants also. The difference between essential prime implicants and normal prime implicant is, essential prime implicant is a prime implicant that must be considered for the final answer, otherwise there is no chance of covering all the ones present in the given question. So some logic cells, some minterms are going to be unique to one product term. That product term is going to be covered only if you that product term is going to be covering that cell, otherwise there is no chance of covering that cell. without including this product term. Such product terms are going to be called as essential prime implicants. Okay, we will elaborate this concept by taking, let us assume, okay, we will go like this. If I am going to include one more one over here, okay, at that time you can get the product terms like this. This will be one more product term, okay, and you can get one more product term like this. So these four are going to be treated as, this is YZ, whereas it is XZ. So there are four prime implicants are possible, but out of that one, these two are essential prime implicants, and third essential prime implicant is nothing but one out of this one. So if you consider one out of this one can be covered, otherwise this one cannot be covered. If you don't consider these two, YZ and XZ, at that time this one cannot be covered in the function. So to cover this one, you must include either YZ or XZ. So these, if you are including XZ, that will be called as essential prime implicant. Okay. So the right answer for the question is A. Thank you.